Back to another MN Talk Show special guest, Max Hoyt and Sophie Hoyt.
Yes.
Welcome to the show.
Welcome.
Appreciate you guys taking the time to come out. Yeah, this is exciting. I'm really excited for this one.
Newlyweds 5 months ago.
I know.
Oh, tell us how that happened. Like, how you guys met. How did you propose? How was the wedding? Give us the rundown. Here we go.
You want to tell your side first?
Sure.
Well, there's going to be two sides.
Whose is more exciting, I guess? Like, I which side
my,
is more
mine ties into my testimony.
Oh, I suppose.
Okay.
So
okay,
I can give you like kind of like the
let's do
long,
that
short version.
However whatever. Long you want to make it. It's all you.
Okay. So he's one of my best friend's brothers.
Okay.
So I met her the last 2 weeks before graduating college. We were not friends in college, but I was like going through a breakup. We got really close and I would see Max here and there.
Yeah.
But
she'd come over to the house. Max,
yeah.
Here.
Did you guys go to the same school?
No.
Different? Oh, no, I suppose.
We were both at Bethel at the same time, but okay. We never saw each other.
She right.
Was like a junior.
I didn't know who he was, and right. I didn't even know his sister until like a little bit later. But we started hanging out, and then that summer after, she moved to Nashville, and then he was in school in Arizona. But I was like, oh, you guys are great. Like, I love you guys. And I'm like starting to get into my faith with Jesus, but also still like tied with the world. So I'm going back and forth, but for some reason, I always felt really good being around Ellie and Max. And so whenever they were home, it was like, I'm going to spend the whole weekend here. I'm going to sleep over, whatever. And obviously, I always thought Max was cute, but I was like, no, I don't need to be with guys right now. I can't, you know, whatever. It was never anything, but I just thought you were cute.
Thanks.
But
gosh, must feel good.
But he, I actually went to GCU and like saw him for a little bit because my brother goes there also. So again, like kind of close friends.
Yeah, just randomly saw each other.
Yeah, like weird connections.
Yeah, we always vibed when we were with each other. Like it was just hilarious hanging out with one another.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I was like, yeah, all right, see ya.
That's
yeah.
sick.
Like, yeah, because we're both funny. So we were like always laughing. And Ellie was there. So anyways.
Did she like pick it up?
I think there's somebody at the door. Or they're just waving at me.
Probably just waving at you.
Cool, hey.
Hey.
You gotta go fight a bitch.
So, I was just about to say, do you know Jesus?
Literally, hey. That's awesome. Anyways, yeah.
Anyways, so she'd come home, we'd all hang out, and he actually was going through a breakup then too, and I was like in the process of healing, so yeah. I was like, how are you doing? Whatever.
Yeah.
And then he actually, should I share this? He called me one night.
Yeah, so I got it. So like I was like, I'm going to get this girl back. Like I broke up with her. I shouldn't have done it. I'm going to get this girl. And she lived in another state, and I was like, I'm going to fly out there like the movies.
Yeah.
I'm going to just show up and get her back.
Like the movies.
Right? It always works in Hollywood.
Yeah.
And so I didn't have any money though, and so I called her. I was like, hey, I'm going to go get this girl back. Can you, like, Venmo me some cash? And she was like, go for it.
I was like,
do it.
Get her. Do it.
So she sends
Venmo'd
me money.
Venmo'd him, like, money, which is a fun fact we always say.
Wow.
I Venmo'd him money to go win back his ex-girlfriend.
So, like, yeah, that is so I was like, man, I appreciate you, Soph. You're the best.
Yeah. Yeah, right? And then for you to think he's, like, cute at, like, the time, I guess, like, that's pretty ballsy, I'd say.
Like, deep down where you're like, God, I hope it doesn't work out.
Well, when he called me, I was like, oh, he wants me to hang out with him, whatever. Yeah. I was like, maybe this can be a little secret thing.
She thought I was calling her for a booty call. That's what it was.
And then here he is. He's like, I want my ex-girlfriend.
I was like, oh. Switch of events, do it. I'll give you money. I'm here to support, whatever. So anyways, didn't work out. But throughout that time, it was like, keep me updated. Like, how are you doing? Mm. And then when he got back, he was like, let's go out like for half apps.
Yeah,
and I'm like,
just talk about
okay,
it.
Yeah. You just want to talk about your breakup, whatever. But like the whole time we just talked about Jesus. Like we didn't even really talk about that. And I was like, wow.
Really?
This is crazy. Like I've never felt this way with somebody else before. Because I have always just like lived in the world. I always like partied, was always with guys. Mm-hmm. That's like what I found fulfilling. But in that season, I was like, I'm so bored with that. Like, I'm not feeling good. I'm not feeling fulfilled. And then when I'm like with Ellie, when I'm with Max, they don't do that stuff, but I feel so good.
Right.
So I was always just like so intrigued with who they were. But he was like, I'm going to go to Bible school in Pittsburgh. And so I was like, dang it. Now you guys are both gone. Like, I'm doomed. So he basically asked me if I wanted to drive with him to Nashville to see Ellie, to switch cars, and then to drive him to Pittsburgh, and then he would buy my flight back home.
Oh, what a guy.
And I'm like,
gentleman,
I guess. Yeah. And he's thinking that we're like super close.
Yeah, I thought we were like besties.
Yeah. At the time. And I was like, oh, you want me to go with you? Like, okay. Okay. I was like, we're not that close.
Right.
I just helped you.
You were just buddies.
Yeah, yeah, we're just buddies. But anyways, it happened, and I got in the car with him, and as we're driving there, he was like, oh, by the way, I got two job offers back home in Minnesota. So basically, we're driving to Nashville, and we might be turning right back around, and I might be not going to Pittsburgh. And I'm like, what the heck? What's the point of this road trip then? Yeah. Why am I coming with you? Right. But okay. And the whole time we're driving there, it was so fun. Like 15 hours, probably 17 hours because we kept missing turns. But we were like laughing. We were jamming to throwback music. Yep. We talked about Jesus, and literally we got so deep with Jesus.
There was like no secrets left in the car.
No secrets.
Really? We told each other everything.
How, I guess, relieving was that? Like, because I suppose neither of you talked about it very often with like any of your other friends beforehand, right? So like, I guess how, like, off your chest was that, that car ride, I guess?
It was great. I mean, before a car ride, I actually like needed to tell Max my full testimony, like everything that I've ever done, everything that I thought I could not be forgiven for. And I told him, and I like felt so light after. And so in the car, it was like deeper of like, why? What does the Bible say about this? Because I grew up in a Christian home, but I never understood the deeper meaning of anything. And I've never seen anything cool. So I'm like, oh, it's just dead, whatever. Yeah. But in the car with him, he would teach me all these super deep things. I'm like, no. And it wasn't like a,
it's like, way.
I don't believe it. It's like a
way.
Literally no way. But I think the biggest thing for me is every time we stopped or pulled over and went to a gas station, he would go pray for people. He would literally do the things that he talked about. We talked about in the car, which was the coolest thing because I'm like, you're actually like, this is true.
You actually
like,
I
trust you way more.
Talk,
yeah. Like, I trust you way more with the things you're doing because that's weird. Like, I remember we were like buying something, and he like asked the girl, like, hey, are you going through anything? Like, can I pray for you? And I'm like, oh my gosh, just give me my candy. This is so weird.
I'll take my Kit Kat.
But then we got in the car, and he just like explained to me, and we just like dove deep. And I don't know, we just got super like intimate with one another spiritually and emotionally. But then we could also have fun, because I think that was another big piece for me is, like, Christians can't have fun. So I was like, it's going to be boring. But it was the
trying
best
to have a balance of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, has it been hard to find that balance, or is it easier with Max and obviously vice versa?
Yeah, it's so easy.
I think it's been.
It's so fun. Like, so fun. Now I'm, like, so hungry for all of my friends or everyone to be like, I want you to experience the things that I've experienced without trying to be filled by this world, because those are the things you have to, like, cope with things. But, like, on this side of things, it's so much freedom, and it's amazing, and it's so fun, and I don't know.
And you get to do it with a good group of people, obviously.
Yeah.
I mean, what you guys have going over in Rogers is, like, unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean,
awesome, man.
Just the pictures and the videos and stories I've seen, it's like, wow.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah.
Was that car ride down to Nashville, like, God, maybe this is more than a friendship?
Yeah, so, like, for me, at least, I had sworn off women. I was like, I'm done with women. And so
what?
I was like, I'm done.
Cause it was breakup.
It was my breakup.
Like,
I was like,
I'm done.
I was like, dude, I'm going like the Apostle
Paul
route.
As he's asking me to go on his road trip with him.
Yeah. Can we talk about that? Like flight to your ex-girlfriend?
Totally.
Like, how did that go? Did you just like knock on our dorm room and there was another dude, or like, was it one of those? Cause I've seen videos before where like, how did that go? And then we'll loop back in.
Yeah. I told my family, I was like, hey, I'm gonna do this. They're like, hey, don't do that. And I was like, well, I'm going to do it. This is foolproof. In the movies, it always works. I was like, Ryan Reynolds wouldn't let me down. Like, this is what happens in his movies, so it's going to work for me. And I hop on the plane, and I'm like telling everybody, while I'm like, they're like, why are you going to Cali? And I was like, oh, man, you know, I'm going to go win this girl back. So I had the whole plane on my side. They're like, go do it. And I was like, yeah,
yeah,
I am.
This is going to be a perfect love story.
I like get off the plane, and I'm like, all right, I'm going to just pull up to her house. Uber to her house, like an hour Uber, get there. I got like chocolates, roses, and then I like go and knock on the door. There's like no answer, and I'm like, there's no chance that like
nobody's
this gone. Is the one weekend that like she's gone. You know what I mean? I was like, this would be trash. So then I like walked down to the back, knocked on the door, and her mom pulled up. And I was like, hey, I was like, is she home? And she goes, yeah, let me go get her. So she brings her down. And it was just this moment of just like, holy crap, like, you're actually here right now, like, from Minnesota.
Her mom, like, that was her mom's, like, face or, like,
yeah, her mom's face and then her face as well. Like, they're both just shocked. And basically, I just, like, told her, I was like, hey, like, I would love to try this again, be together, like, you know, all this stuff. And she just, like, I know now that, like, it was the grace of God to, like, just close that door.
Yeah.
Right? To lead me, obviously, to Sophie. And where she, like, looked me dead in the face and she was like, no. And I was like, What?
What do you mean, no?
I see my chocolates?
I was like,
are you kidding me?
I was like, I just flew here on a plane without, like, showed up romantically. Yeah. Like, this works. Yeah.
You know? You're still outside during this whole conversation.
Yeah. And I'm just like, well, no.
Did I hear that right?
You know what I mean? Like, I don't have a hotel. I don't have nothing. I was just planning to stay with them. You know what I mean? So I'm like, this is going to work. This is going to work.
Yep.
And I even remember praying before I left. And I was like, Lord, just give me wisdom in this. And I remember hearing his voice so clearly being like, it's not going to work. And I was like, yeah, I'm just going to disregard that one. We're going to go anyways.
That's so funny. That's not funny, but like, that's so funny.
I go, it's kind of funny. I'm sorry you did that. But.
So now I'm out in California, and I like hit up my buddy Marcus. I'm like, hey, man, I'm out in Cali. She didn't take me back. I need a place to stay.
Yeah.
So he lets me stay with him for like 2-3 days, and then I just hop back on a plane. And it was a fun little trip then. I got to like go see La Jolla, chill out at the beach.
As like, you're like heartbroken.
So it's like, yeah, it was like a loss, but a win.
Did you at least give her the flowers and chocolates?
I gave her the flowers and chocolates. She did take them. And then it was the most awkward part was that she said no. There wasn't much of a conversation. There was like a 5-minute conversation after that as to why. But then...
Was her mom like still there?
Her mom went inside.
Oh, okay. Did you have to like walk away because your Uber like?
Dude, so I was so this is the bad. This is like, this is why you listen to the voice of the Lord. Because like I was so confident in my own hopes that I like sent the Uber away. I was like, hey, bro, you're good. Take off. So now I'm like, I got to call another Uber. And it's like, yeah, he'll be there in 13 minutes. So now I just have to sit outside her house and wait. And she's like, do you want me to sit out here with you? And I was like, no. Just go inside.
So you just sat in your ex-girlfriend's front lawn.
Yeah.
Waiting for your Uber to come.
Yep. I was just chilling.
I wonder if there's like a picture of her like taking it from her bedroom. Oh, like, God. Look at this idiot who showed up.
On her private story or something. Like, look 100%. At this goofy.
Yeah. She came from Minnesota to come
get
me back.
How old were you at the time?
Dude, I was 21.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. How long were you guys together then?
6 months.
Oh, Max.
Yeah.
Yeah. You were there for 6 months? You flew to Cali for it?
Yeah, dude. Oh. That's what I'm telling you. That's what I'm telling you. I was not in the right mindset.
And God told you don't
and
do it.
And he told me no. He told
and you're like, man.
So the reason that I broke up with her was because, like, we were very different spiritually.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I was already working ministry at the time.
Yeah.
And so, like, I was leading a student ministry at GCU. So I was getting to experience the Lord like never before. Like, the craziest of miracles, the craziest of stuff. And she wasn't really, like, for that. Like, she wasn't against it, but she just wasn't. It wasn't her thing. It wasn't the life that she wanted. And I was like, okay. And so I was like, I have to end this. Like, if this is the life I want to live and that's the life you want to live, it's just not going to work, right?
Right.
So then I broke up with her, and I was like, yeah, I made the right choice. And then also I was like,
I did not make it.
Yeah, dude, like, my mind just played with me, right? Like, the devil got in there, and he's like, go get her back. So I wasted, like, $1,000 on that trip. Yeah, dude.
At least it turned into, like, something kind of fun.
Yeah,
and now you got a sick story from it. Exactly. Like, now your now wife is, like...
And that's the whole reason we went to Applebee's, was to just want to hear all about it. So without that, probably wouldn't have gotten Applebee's.
That's true.
That's true.
What'd you get at Applebee's?
Probably some apps. Yeah, apps, some boneless wings.
Boneless wings
are the way to go.
I think we sat there for like 3 hours. We just talked.
The waiters are probably sitting there like, are these guys ever going to...
You know what's funny? You know who the waiter was? We can blank her name out, but it was oh my gosh. She went to Rogers. She's seen her sister's name is Whitney.
Whitney.
Oh my gosh, Mackenzie.
Mackenzie Laugh?
No,
Mackenzie Meyer.
Yes, Mackenzie Meyer.
No way.
She was the waitress.
I'm just picturing you sitting in this like Applebee's and Rogers.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh yeah, that's where he would be.
It's so funny, dude. I remember seeing her. I was like, is that oh hey, what's up, Mackenzie? Just telling about my heartbreak right now. So
that's so funny. Yeah. So I like you said, like you guys were just like friends of friends. So then like when did it kind of come to you that you were like, yeah, this is the lady I want to be with for the rest of my life?
So during our road trip, I had never really like after I broke up with that girl, I was like, okay, I'm done with women. Like I'm just going to be single. And then we just had like the best of times. And I started to feel this feeling of like, this is dope. Whatever I'm doing is awesome. It would be so much better if Sophie was there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, no matter what I was doing. And then like, she was the first girl who ever like threw gasoline on my fire for Jesus. Like I could just be me. I didn't have to not talk about certain things, mm-hmm. or like she didn't care if I ran up to pray for people or like do stuff like that. It was just like she loved it.
She didn't find it awkward or embarrassing, and it was just like normal.
Well, yeah. Besides, besides the gas station,
she did.
Go you.
So on that road trip, for sure, it was like it was something unique about her. And then, like part of the road trip, we got down to Nashville, and we were gonna go to Pittsburgh, but then the Lord told me, he's like, go back to Minnesota. Like, I have something better for you. So I was like, cool. Like, we hop back in the car, we start heading back to Minnesota, and we just stayed friends after that for a while. And we had the best of times. We were doing Bible study together.
For 6 months.
Really?
We were best friends.
And you're like, yeah, I want to be more.
I really liked him. But this was also my season of, like, I can't keep turning to guys to, like, get my fulfillment.
Right.
And I'm growing in my faith. So I remember after the road trip, I kind of shoved him out. I didn't reply to his Snapchats. I was just like ghosting him. I was like, I don't want to talk to you because I think I'm in love with you. But the Lord literally was like, no, he needs to be in your life. And so I remember kind of like having this conversation, and I was like, okay, if he's going to be in my life, you have to protect my heart, because I'm not getting heartbroken anymore, because that's one of the worst feelings ever. So for 6 months, I loved him, but it was also, I had so much protection. So every time we hung out, it was very Jesus and Holy Spirit and just fun. I just wanted to be with him all the time. And all my friends were like, oh my gosh, so this is dangerous. Like, you like him and blah, blah, blah. But I honestly had to figure out what I wanted, because I was still partying and doing those things. And I was like, I can't be with him because he's not going to do that. And that's a priority for me.
Right.
And then after I messed up and messed up and messed up, I was like, I just want to tell Max, because he directs me towards something that makes me feel so good. And so every time I did that, it was like, this is so dumb. Soph, get your act together. And I finally did. And it was like, I figured out my own priorities. I figured out who I was. I figured out my own identity. And the day that I was like, I'm good. I don't need Max anymore. I'm going this way. I love him and I can't keep being friends with him.
Yeah.
The day I was going to do that was the day that he randomly kissed me at 3 a.m. And then we started dating.
Yeah.
Dude, that's so random.
It's climax.
Literally. It's okay, time to turn life
down. It's long story short, but yeah.
Well, after
the day. Sorry.
Yeah, no, you're fine. After the road trip, we got back and I was like, cool, I'm going to start doing all this other stuff. We're still just going to be buddies. And she's pushing me away, but I was like, I'm staying around.
We're
gonna be best friends. You know what I mean? And that's something I always told her. I was like, I'm in your life now. You're kind of stuck with me.
Yeah.
You know? And I think it was in October, I went down to visit my buddies in GCU. And so this was a month after the road trip. And I was with my buddy Evan. And he asked me, he's like, hey, right now, if you had to marry a girl, who would it be? And her brother went to GCU. And we all knew him. We were friends with him. And so I was like, you know Harley Kendall? He's like, yeah. I was like, his sister. Which is her. I was like, I'd marry her right now. And he's like, why? And I was like, dude, she just has a hunger for Jesus. And I was like, I always want to be around her.
There's just something about her. Yeah.
Yeah. It's just there. And so he's like, cool, man. And I was like, yeah, cool. And then we just went back to life. I didn't make a move on it. I didn't even think about that. I was like, you should maybe, dive into that.
Yeah.
He even told me that. He came back to tell me about the trip and we're hanging out. And he even told me that. And in my head, I'm like,
it just went right over your head. You didn't even think
about
it.
For me, I'm like, I'm it.
I'm right here. Come here. Please.
How did you?
Together.
Yeah, I was going to say, how did you propose? Because I've seen lately where people are they'll propose in the car or somewhere normal. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This has got to be a good story.
One of our proposal video, whatever, blew up.
Mm-hmm.
And so.
Yeah, 10 million views.
We have
What?
What?
Yeah.
Can we see it?
Yeah.
You can get it on your phone.
Yeah.
But it's funny because if you look at the comments, a lot of people
I got dragged through the mud.
Fun of him.
Why?
And there's literally still people to this day still arguing and fighting. And
people hated it.
And it's you guys know I don't have any time.
So I'll give the backstory to this quick.
Yeah.
So we started dating in January and then of that year. And that night I just randomly kissed her. I was like, oh cool, it's the time. I felt like it was just
and I was are we a thing?
So
what were you doing? Cool. Were you just sitting in a car together?
No, so we actually went to a Bible study and then we went out to downtown Minneapolis and took just fun pics.
Okay.
And then we were hanging out. I texted her in the car on the way back and I was like, hey, do you just want to hang out, eat some food?
Yeah.
At her place. And she's like, yeah.
At midnight. I'm like, sure.
Yeah. Why not? So we just like hung out, ate some chicken nuggets, watched some Netflix.
Nuggies.
Like actually having like fun, right? Classic.
And I'm over here like, oh, I got to talk to him and be like, we can't keep doing these things if we're not dating. I can't keep FaceTiming you at 3 a.m. talking like, all night, whatever.
Yeah, right. You're, yeah, and you're just like, I'm just trying to be my wife anyway.
I'm just trying to hang out.
So then, and you're probably thinking like, oh.
And I knew it was coming. Like I could feel it of like, oh, I'm going to be with her. Yeah. And then that night we were like saying goodbye and I just like pulled her in and gave her a kiss.
Yeah.
And then, like, you know, sparks flew. She was like, oh, my gosh, I love you.
I did not. This
is, like, the best love story ever. Like, and then, people think High School Musical is good.
Dude, we hung out
and then we broke
that.
Out in song.
No, we just sat back down and, like, hung out for a couple more hours and just, like, talked about everything. But so then, quick story. We only dated for 5.5 months. And then we got engaged. Mm-hmm. And then we were engaged for 3 months, and then we were married.
Yeah.
Okay.
Really? We knew so you guys have only really been together for, like...
Just over a year.
Yeah.
And so we knew we were going to move quick.
Yeah.
But I'll show you guys. This is...
I'm so excited for this.
People either loved it or hated it.
You make me feel like I never had my heart broken. Like I never saw a door closing. Like I never watched love run away.
That dude, that's such an awesome video.
Yeah,
love like, that.
Yeah,
so people make fun of you for that,
or no. They're like, "Oh, if he's gonna propose, like she's more worthy than a parking ramp."
Yeah, they're
blah,
like,
blah, blah,
"All
blah.
The fake ones were better." And I'm like, "Screw you!"
I'm
guys.
Like, "Do you see the city view? You
I'm like trying to fight for my life."
That was in Minneapolis, right?
That was. Yeah, nice. That was right in North Loop.
Yeah.
Nice.
And so yeah, we just.
Yeah, that thing's it's a little picky. That's you're right. Good.
We the first time that we really hung out. We went to this, I wanted like some pics taken of me for like a birthday. Mm-hmm. And so I was like turning 22 and I just wanted to throw some stuff up on the Instagram.
Mm-hmm. I think it was just an excuse to hang
probably.
Out.
Probably. Yeah, of course it was. Look at him. Yeah.
And
like he's in love with me.
We went out and that was actually before the road trip.
It was.
Which is cool. Yeah. But we went out and she just took some pics of me. And
on that rooftop.
On that rooftop. And so that was like our first hangout spot. And so the day that we got engaged, I was like, hey, like I took her to Boom Island. We had a picnic. We did a Bible study. We did like the stuff we love to do.
Yeah.
And then we went over there and I was like, hey, wouldn't it be so cool? Because we really feel called to like Minneapolis right now. And I was like, wouldn't it be so cool if we just like praise and worshiped up here? Like looking at the rooftop, let's just like praise the Lord. Like mm-hmm. we love this relationship. We're so thankful for what he's bringing us. Let's just do that. And she loves praise and worship. And so I was like, you should set up your phone because, you know, social media marketer. I was like, you can get content.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm. So I take videos of everything.
Yeah. Right?
And so she sets her phone up and then we start just like worshiping. And then I eventually got down on one knee.
Well, he like tapped me and I was like, you're not going to do it. Like, yeah, he always faked it. Yeah. So I was like, whatever. Here I kept worshiping. Go. And then he kept doing it. So I turned around and he's on his knee and I was like, I swear if you're faking this time.
And then he whips out the ring.
Yeah, and then he whips out the ring and I was like,
it was real. And so that's like a fun little backstory to the parking garage. But nobody else knows that.
Yeah.
So to everybody else, it's like, oh, parking garage.
Yeah, parking garage. She's more really. Yeah, I get that. God, that is so crazy.
That's your own movie. I know you were chasing a movie on a plane to California, but your movie was sitting right here in Minnesota the entire time.
The whole time.
Dude, we have to like produce this. Can we like, can you guys like
movie in the making?
Yeah, we have, bro.
We can make this like a 6-hour long podcast and I want detailed details. Yeah. Like, this is unbelievable. I wish we could be here all night. Yeah. I know you got to pick up parents from the airport. But we could be here.
They could wait. They could join the podcast.
They would. They would love that. Yeah.
So, what did your parents, I guess, think of it? Can we bring them into it too? Like, I mean, you guys. Well,
yeah, that's actually a really good question.
Two different sides of marriage spectrum there. So, like, my mom and dad. My dad's from Cali. My mom's from Minnesota. They met 1 week later. They were engaged.
Wow.
And then 6 months later, they're married.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they're very fast.
So they're like,
they've been together for 35 years.
Yeah. Okay.
And so his siblings all got married.
My brother met his wife after like 4 months, proposed, got married. He was in the military.
Gotcha.
My sister is probably going to do, my oldest sister did the same. It was like super fast.
Yeah.
And then it was like my turn. I was like, well,
super fast. Here we go.
They're literally, it's like month into us dating, and they're like, "When are you gonna propose? When are you guys?"
They were like, "If you know, you know. Like, just do it."
Yeah.
Right.
And I was like, "That's great advice for if you really know."
Yeah. Like, that's it, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I was like, I was just on a plane trying to get to another girl. So let me take a little more time. Let me take some time.
Yeah.
It's funny because I was the slow one, which I'm like, dude, it's 5.5 months.
Yeah. What? Yes. That is not normal. I guess.
Not at all.
And my family's so opposite. Like, it was actually kind of scary to try and meet up with my dad, because my dad, obviously me being the only girl,
right,
but also having Max try and talk to him within 5 months of us dating was scary. And like, my oldest brother is married, but he dated his now wife for like a year, then they broke up for a year, but then dated for like 2 more years,
right,
and then they like got married, and we were like, okay,
normal,
it's a good timeline. Or like, yeah, my other siblings, I guess, have been, or my other brother dated his girlfriend for a year, and I dated someone for 3 years. So it's just like,
yeah,
you date, you the just length, take yeah, your time. Yeah. We're like,
what's the rush?
I was more like that
though.
Right,
so when Max was like not rushing, but like very quick to do things, and his whole family, it was like, I was kind of overwhelmed. Yeah. But then I also,
as you said, at the same time, we didn't want to have sex.
Yeah,
right.
We wanted to save it for marriage.
Yeah.
And so like, that was a big part of us, is like, when you're born again, like, you're a virgin again. Like, mm-hmm. Christ forgets all of your past sins. And we're like, we want to be each other's first. So right. We want to do this in marriage.
Yeah.
If you're with somebody for more than a year, unless you are a tough cookie, bro.
Yeah.
You're stronger than me. Yeah. You're probably going to do it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh, like, yeah. God.
So we knew, like, we're each other's person. Yeah. We're going to get going.
With our story on a spiritual level, we both knew that we were going to be together.
Right.
So it was like, we just want to live together. We want to travel together.
Just do life together.
Yeah. We just want to do that. And if we know we're it, and if we can have fun with each other and laugh about everything and have Jesus as the center, it's like, all right, bring at us whatever.
How'd that conversation go with her dad?
I was just gonna ask that.
Like,
it was a little bit of a struggle to actually get the meeting, because he knew what it was about. Yeah. I think.
Oh, you know, really?
So I think he was just trying to push it off
to get the meeting.
Yeah,
got a business meeting that with your pops in a little bit.
So like, I told her, I was like, hey, I've tried like a couple times. If I can't get this, I'm just gonna ask you.
Yeah, and he told me that, and I'm like, no, you need my dad's approval.
I was gonna say, from like a female standpoint, that's gotta be scary.
Yeah, I was like, no.
But then it lined up.
It did, but I didn't know that. So in my head, that's why I was so surprised that he proposed, because I was like, he does not have my dad's approval. I'm gonna have to go talk to him. And whatever.
Yeah. I went and got it on a weekend that she was gone. But that conversation was like, it was the funniest conversation, but at the same time, it was the most wholesome. Because I could tell how much he loved Soph.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was like, wow, like, we vibe. Like, I really love her too. Yeah. And
we got something in common.
Makes two of us.
And we like, so he knew I was there. And right as I get there, you know, he gives me the, how you doing, son, handshake. And he grabs me a dilly bar, and he takes a dilly bar, and I'm like, sir. Like,
he's probably just so nervous.
I was like, I'm not really in the mood for a dilly bar right now. Like, I'm trying to ask for permission to marry your daughter, and I know this is not your style. So we go out to the deck, and he's like licking his dilly bar, and I'm like trying to be like, yeah, like, I love your daughter, and like, I'll provide for her.
Who licks a dilly bar though? Okay,
like,
what are we doing here?
Oh, so there's a minute that like, he like went to bring the dog inside or something, and I was like, dude, F this dilly bar. I just like chomped the whole thing and chucked it. And then he came back, and I was like, that was delicious. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Like, let's just get to the point.
Yeah.
So then it was really cool though. We just talked about, you know, faith. We talked about why. We talked about pros, the cons. What am I going to do to provide? Like, all this stuff.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the night, you know, he was just like, yeah, like, you've got it, but kind of at the same time, I can tell he was
scared,
weary, you know what I mean, to hand it out that fast. Mm-hmm.
Especially with, like, his only daughter. Exactly. I mean, like, it's a, you screw up, you're done. Like, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it was a great conversation. And then I remember we went into the kitchen, and he asked me if I wanted a beef stick. And this is the guy he is. He's, like, the nicest dude in the world. He's like,
he
so
loves
nice.
His beef sticks.
Dilly bars, beef sticks.
So he hands me this like foot-long beef stick. So I'm holding this foot-long beef stick. And he asked me another question about like work. So I'm like, I gotta explain how I'm gonna bring income in and while doing ministry with this foot-long beef stick. And I'm just like, well, you know,
like, just going back
laughing everywhere. And so I'm like, what am I doing right now?
What a weird conversation.
So that's hilarious.
Yeah. It went great. And then I got to leave and left with a beef stick, and it was awesome.
Did you feel like you're like, yeah, I feel good about this now. Like, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, because I was like, I knew I needed it.
Yeah.
So I was like, otherwise it's just gonna be awkward.
Yeah.
You know, right. Like, I was already the new guy in the family.
Yeah.
Right. I was already like, this weird dude kind of who like has seen crazy healings on the streets and like bringing in some stuff like that that they weren't like used to. Mm-hmm. And so I always knew like I was a little bit of the weird one.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
And that's so, all right. Yeah, somebody's got to be the weird one. Exactly. Right?
So it was really nice to do one thing right.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I suppose. Yeah. That's a win. Yeah. I love that.
It worked out great.
God, what a story you guys have.
I mean, this entire podcast is about like faith in God and your guys' journey. How did that start? Why'd you start following him? Was it from when you were born? Like, it was just what your parents did? Or, like, was there a big thing in your life that's like, I need that guy right now?
Mm, that's a good question.
I know it's, like, deep, but, like...
Yeah. Do you want to go first?
Sure. Yeah. So, like, I grew up in a very faith-filled household. Okay. Like, ever since I was born, like, just experiencing the Lord, loving the Lord, like, living for him. And then... I had like a little bit of a low moment in high school. I wasn't the best dude. Everybody thought that I was like a good guy, but I knew I wasn't. Like I was kind of just sleazy, scumbag, like wasn't a good dude. And I went to college and still kind of that same guy. And I was just getting into like kind of the world side, like hooking up with chicks all the time, establishing like some bad addictions. And like I was like hardcore hooked on porn and sex. And like it was so bad, like actually addicted. And I just got to this point where I was like, I need to be free. Like, whatever, I'm half into this faith thing, I'm half out, like, I need to pick a side, right? And I went to my pastor, Terrence Reeves Chong, and we just had a great day, and we talked about everything that I had done, and I was like, I feel like such a fake, you know what I mean? Because, like, everybody knew me as the faith guy, goes to FCA, you know, could ask him questions about Jesus, he could answer them, but at the same time, like, I'm doing everything that the world is doing, I'm just pretending I don't.
Right.
You know? And, like... I told him everything, and then we prayed, and I had never gone more than, like, probably a day without getting my fix of whatever it was with somebody by myself or whatever, and I went 3 weeks, and also I looked back, and I was like, holy crap. I was like, I just went 3 weeks. I've never gone 3 weeks without watching this stuff. You know, I had such, like, a hold on my life, and most guys know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And,
yeah.
And it's like every time, right, you're like, I'm not going to do it again. I'm not going to do it again. I'm not going to do it. You're going to do it again.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, because you're trying to break it by yourself, and you can't. You know, you're trying to bring a like a physical approach to something that's spiritual. And so I was like, wow, this is for real. And I was like, I want to do this. I want to actually live this life out. Mm-hmm. And so I went down to GCU. I had just sold my business at the time, and I was like, I don't know what I'm going to do. And so I went down to GCU, and I met some guys, Siraj Thomas and Evan Finley. And dude, they just walked with the Holy Spirit. Like they lived this thing out. And I remember asking Siraj one night, I was like, dude, like, and, like, I grew up believing in, like, miracles are for today. People can get healed. People can get set free from stuff. And, like, I've experienced it. And I saw this dude, Siraj, and I was like, you walk in, like, the miraculous. Like, I've seen you do stuff.
Yeah.
I want to do that. Like, I want to live that life. And he's like, all right, man. And he kind of took me under his wing. And we're, like, he's in my wedding. We're, like, best friends now. But we started just doing, like, we'd walk the streets of Phoenix and we'd just like talk to homeless people, talk to prostitutes, talk to pagans. Like it was the coolest thing. Yeah. And like, I was seeing the craziest of miracles happen. Like I was seeing people's like busted hands, like the bones get reset. I was seeing people who are blind. Like we'd pray for them and their eyes would open up on the spot. Really? And I was like this 21-year-old freshly like giving his life back to Jesus. And I was like, oh my gosh. I was like, I've read about this. I've seen kind of other people experience stuff like that. But I was like, this is my first time like, really experiencing it, you know what I mean?
And it's firsthand. It's not like it's a story from somebody else. Like
right.
You get to hear
it, so. I had always heard so many stories. Uh-huh. And so walking that out and like seeing people get touched and saved, we started doing a student-led ministry. And it just grew and grew and grew to where I was preaching to kids on Mondays and I was walking them through street evangelism. And it was like, oh my gosh. Like it seemed like everybody we prayed for was getting healed. It seemed like everywhere we went, it was just like Holy Spirit led. Like I would get words of knowledge for people. Like even on our honeymoon, there's this awesome lady where I just felt this pain in my back and it went down through my left leg. And I walked up to her and I was like, hey, you have pain in your back and it goes down through your leg, right? She was like, what leg? And I was like, your left leg. And she goes, who told you that? And I was like, God did. Like he loves you so much. He wants to heal you right now. And she said no to the prayer. And I was like, all right, cool. But like some stranger just told you exactly what you're feeling. You might want to look into that.
Yeah.
Just remember this moment. But stuff like that started happening. And I was like, this is it. Like, this is a life of power. Like, even the hat. What hat am I wearing?
Bass Pro.
Dang it. I was gonna wear my Acts 1:8 hat. Yeah. But it's like it says like when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you'll be endued with power. Mm-hmm. And I was always like, that's a cool verse. But I was like, no, like that's me. Like if you have the Holy Spirit, you have power, and that power is to set people free.
Yeah.
And so we just started. I just started living that out down at GCU, and just slowly got more on fire and on fire and on fire. And I was like, this is awesome. Like, I wasn't even working really ministry. I was a kinesiology major.
Right.
But yet people were getting touched and saved and healed everywhere we went. I was like, this is ministry. You know what I mean? Like, not just from the pulpit. Like, this is ministry. Like, let's live this thing out.
For sure.
And so that's where I really got set on fire was GCU. And then I ended up coming back home, and I gave up GCU, and I gave up my basketball dreams. I wanted to coach in the NBA. And I just laid that all down for the Lord because I felt like he was calling me to something bigger. So I was like, all right, cool. I lay it down. And then very quickly after that, just opportunities started popping up to get to preach and teach, and met Sophie. And then we got to do our road trip. And that, like, that whole thing led into that. Mm-hmm. So then now we get to do ministry together. And like, we have so many opportunities now to like travel and preach and teach. And we've gotten to see in Rogers, Minnesota, like of all places, see young men come in and get their blind eyes healed. People come in with like severe scoliosis. We've prayed for them and their back like completely aligns.
Straightens out, huh?
Just like the most wild of stuff that like, I was like, man, in Rogers? Like I've heard of this in Africa, bro. But
not Rogers. Right? And it's like, it's different because it's your hometown. Like, those are people that like you know or have
literally,
a similar story.
Like, I know their parents and stuff. And like, even like getting to like baptize people and like see their lives change. Like Olivia, getting to see her whole testimony play out. Mm-hmm. Getting to see Allison's testimony like play out. That's like kind of where, like, living a life with the Holy Spirit is what's just cooked us on fire for Jesus.
Yeah.
At least for me. Yeah. And then,
obviously yours is a little bit different, but my God, that's
like
unbelievable.
Crazy. It's so cool to like hear you say that.
Do you hear it a lot? Like, is it almost like an everyday thing, or is it just like kind of whenever somebody asks, it's
like about his story?
About, well, like, either one, like if somebody asks about yours or yours.
Yeah.
Like,
I feel like a lot of people are like intrigued with our life.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like we talk more about what's happening today.
Right.
So it's kind of cool to kind of go back into that moment or just hear what happened back then before I was around, and then when I was around, and now what's going on today. So it's cool to go back and
for sure
where you came from.
Yeah. And experience that. That's
definitely different.
And then we met and you were in your faith and
What's your story like? Like how did you what was your kickoff?
Okay. I grew up in the church, but I was Baptist. So great. But just everything was kind of dead. You know, it was like my parents were great, raised me, and we went to a Christian high school, Christian middle school, everything. So I was always around Christians, but you know, there was still obviously like the worldly things like gossip and bullying and whatever. And so I think I was so confused with like, what's the difference? Mm-hmm. I more so thought it was just like a coping thing of if you're going through something, read the Bible, turn to Jesus, great. But if you're not, just live your life.
Mm-hmm.
And even too, I think like, choose God, and then it's family and friends and sports, whatever. But like for me, it was always sports. I skipped church all the time to go to sports. So I think I kind of grew up just a little confused. I knew there was a God, but didn't really do anything about it. So I ended up getting obviously into the party scene at 15, and that was all we did. Like every single weekend, that's what I would mostly do to just like fit in with like public schools or even like
my
school.
Like, if you didn't party, you were lame.
If you didn't party, you were a loser. So I was like, I have to. And I'm super extroverted. I always wanted to just be like that person that
extroverted
people wanted
you?
Around. I know, right? Isn't that crazy?
Wild. Yeah. Would have never guessed.
But anyways, so that just kind of like became my life, what I surrounded myself with. And then going into college, same thing. You kind of just like find those friends who do the same things you did. And my senior year of college, it was, I actually dyed my hair black. Ooh. So every time someone's like, I'm gonna dye my hair black, I'm like, don't do it.
Don't do it. Your life just changes.
But my life is just, I don't know, crazy. Like my boyfriend broke up with me. My dad had like medical issues. Like it was COVID. It was just like a really tough year. But obviously, the only thing that I turned to was drinking and partying and filling myself with all these things that I just wanted right away. So I actually just, like, drank all the time, like, 6-7 days a week. I didn't even care. It was just, like, everything I wanted to do. And, again, I just wanted to be that girl who would, like, do everything. I wanted to be that person. So I just kind of got into the people pleasing and just lived my life for other people,
right,
which caused me to be so much more like insecure and filled with negative self-talk or even lust, dealing with porn ever since I was 15 as well. And so there was just so many things I was dealing with, but I didn't know what it was. I didn't know how to address it. People always said like, oh, pray, do this. And he was like, I'm not going to do that. It's not making me feel better right
yeah.
now.
Yeah, it's not instant gratification.
So I don't want to do it. But when I graduated, I moved out randomly. My parents did not want me to. They got super mad. But I was like, I have to move out because I want to do all these fun things by myself. And I had like $50 in my bank account. And I'm like, sweet, okay. But I just got a job.
Yeah.
And I like worked at this job for like 3 weeks. And then they let me go with mm-hmm. COVID stuff. So I was like, cool. Now I
living
can't
on my
afford
own, don't have money. Yeah.
But I was like, I can't like have my parents be right.
Right.
So I remember I was also like close with Ellie, his sister, who was also very just like into her faith. So I was like, mm-hmm. okay, you're cool and you also love Jesus. So I kind of want to be like that. So I was like praying more. So in that moment, I remember I was like, Lord, I need a job. I'm like so anxious right now. I need money, blah, blah, blah. And like 2 hours later, I got an email from a bridal shop. It was like, hey, are you looking for a job right now? Because we're hiring. And I was like, oh my gosh, what? And so I was like, yes. And so I worked there for a year. And the owner, it loves the Lord. It's a Christian store. And she really like dove deep on me.
Yeah.
Like I was so honest and open with her, which is weird for me. I'm not really open with a lot of strangers.
Right.
I am now because I love Jesus and right. I'm free from that. But like in that season, she knew like what I was going through. She knew what I was doing and what I was dealing with. And she believed, obviously, a lot of the things that Ellie and Max did. And so I was like, oh, this isn't scaring me because they do
you were hearing
too.
It from somebody else yeah. instead of just one person.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So she would, like, pray over me or, like, I would always tell her what I was doing to get attention. But it was dumb because she was like, okay, well, then have fun dealing with that tonight yeah. type thing. You know, like, she would give me hard love. So that was, like, a cool, like, seed. And then after that, I actually did the 75 hard.
Yep.
Which is like the challenge where you can't yeah. drink and you have to work out all the time. And I kind of got roped into doing it. Again, no one thought I could do it because you're not supposed to drink. And so I was like, okay, I'm going to prove you guys all wrong. And I did it.
Yeah.
And I still went out all the time. Though I was like sober cab. And about like the seventh time that I went out, I was like, this is so dumb. Why do I do this yeah. every weekend? Like, why do I work my butt off at work 5 days a week, and then the next 2 or 3 days, I waste it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I see the same people, have the same conversations, wear the same stuff. I'm like, this is not fulfilling. This is so actually depressing.
Right.
And so that's when I was like, okay, I'm going to stay home this weekend. Because I would also get very anxious being by myself, even if it was like alone in my car. I like couldn't do that.
Right.
I had to be like calling someone, whatever. And
needing the attention.
Yeah. So I stayed home alone by myself, and I remember like I was like fighting like anxiety and like all these negative thoughts, and I would call Ellie or whatever. But one day, like I called 20 people, nobody answered. And now I look back, I'm like, that was the Lord being like, just be by yourself, just be alone.
Sit still.
Yeah, sit
still. Yeah.
Yeah. And I remember I just stayed in my room and I just like put on worship music. So I'm like, let's see if this works. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is the best day of my life. Like I feel so good. I watched a movie. I was like reading the Bible. I was worshiping. I was like, what? I can live like this like yeah. every day? And that was kind of my awakening of like, he's real. I have to put in the efforts. I have to put in the work. And I kept praying like, I need great community then because I can't keep being tempted to go out and doing these things. And that's when I got close with Max and Ellie, and even my work was all Christians, and the people I was living with were great.
Yeah, so he just kind of surrounded you by the people that you needed.
Yeah.
To be around. Yeah.
So like I had to get up and go do all these things, but I was also like, Lord, I need girls. I need girls who are going to push me. I don't want to be down and whatnot. And so actually Max introduced me to a lot of great girls who are now like some of my best friends today.
That's awesome.
Who like push me, and I still love like all my old friends, but it's just like this side of things is so much better.
It's a different lifestyle.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah.
So it's like all I want is like just come with me, just like come with me and hang out with me.
Yeah.
Because I want you to be so free from all the things you're going through or whatnot. But the Lord's also just like pray for them. Just like pray for them. And like some of them have. They've reached out. They come to Bible study. They've gotten touched. People who I never thought in a million years would come to Bible study. And so I think also too, something that has sparked this journey is just like seeing the miracles that Max has talked about and diving deep in the word of like, if someone comes in with cancer and they get healed and everything's clear off their body, it's like, okay, this is pretty cool. I want to keep doing this.
So do you guys still go out and like have a drink and like party with your friends, or is that just something that's totally written off your story?
Yeah, so that part of life is just like, it's in the past for us.
Yeah.
Just because like there's like, we'll hang out with people, we'll go out, we'll do stuff, but you know, for us, it's like, I just can't be in a, I don't want to be in a spot where I feel like I'm going to be pulled into something I don't want to be in.
Yeah.
Right.
You know like what I mean? Playing that game with that line.
Yeah. And then like at the same time, like for us, it's almost like there's so many other things that we want to do now.
Yeah.
Right? Like we're being invited to a house party at like St. Thomas or something. Like used to be like, oh, that's so sick. Right. And now for us, it's like, it's not really that
watch
fun,
watch Netflix or like relax or something. Like,
Or like this on Friday, we have worship nights on Fridays.
Yeah.
And then everyone stayed after and we played like karaoke. And then we went to the gas station and we all planned to go to a concert in a couple weeks. It's like there's actually so much to do besides going out to drink, which I never thought was a thing.
Right.
So now that I do it and I'm such a like extroverted, like outgoing person, it's like, okay, I'm that way for a reason. Yeah. So I'm going to use that for like the better, to be like, you guys don't have to just like go sit around and do that, you know, like we're gonna go and have fun, go to concerts, go stay
there's
in
other
and
options.
Fill each other
up. Like there's so many other options besides Sal's or the KK, you know what I mean, like there's so much more in life than just like Dinky Town.
And that's something that we've just like talked about as our relationship. We're like, we just want to say no. Yeah. You know, like, that's just
We want to be different.
Yeah.
Like, that's one thing is, like...
We want people to ask us why and for it to lead into, like, oh, my gosh, like, can we pray for you? Or, like, we're not playing with, oh, that person prayed for me, but they're probably just, like, hammered right now. You know, like, we don't want people to take away our ministry from, like, if we're drunk or not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So...
And, like, part of this, these, like, ministry that we do and, like, these Wednesday nights has come from, like, a lot of just showing people that it's real and that, like... This isn't some like esoteric, like, you know, crazy God like that just sits in the sky and looks at you from a throne. Like, no, he's like a God that like truly loves you and like he wants to fill you. And like some of her friends that came to Wednesday nights, like I ended up getting coffee with one of the dudes, and in the Chipotle parking lot that we were eating at, we like prayed that he'd receive the Holy Spirit, and this dude got hit, bro. Like he was like holding on to me because he was like almost falling down. And he was like, what just happened? I was like, dude, that's the Holy Spirit, man. He just like filled you. He's like, bro, I feel so light right now. I feel good. Mm-hmm. I was like, yeah, bro. I was like, almost like you're like born again, right? And he's like, that's exactly what it is. I was like, yeah.
Wow.
And so like for us, it's just like showing people and telling people that like this thing is real and it's really fun. Like
it's a different experience.
Fun. Dude, there's like nothing really compares to like I was in Arizona and I was at a Walmart and there's this lady named Cherry. And I saw her walking with this crazy limp. And I was like, man, Jesus died so that she could have freedom. Like, she doesn't have to be bound like that. And I walked up to her and I introduced myself and she was very nice. And she had nerve damage in her leg ever since she was a kid. So she's never walked straight. I was like, hey, I want to let you know that, like, Jesus loves you and he wants to fix this leg right now. And she was like, oh, I bet he does. And then she, like, starts to walk away. And I was like, wait a minute. I was like, no, like, right now. And so she let me pray for her leg. And she took 3 steps and it loosened on the spot. And she started walking normal for the first time in her life. And she looked at me just crying. She's like, what did you do? And I was like, I didn't do anything. I was like, that was the Holy Spirit. Like, he loves you so much.
Yeah.
And she's crying. And I'm like, this is awesome. Like, praise the Lord, right? Like, she's going to give her life to Jesus. She's going to be loved for the first time ever. Her husband walks up. He's like 6'5", big dude.
Yeah.
And he's like, what'd you do? And I was like, nothing, bro.
Nothing, bro.
Relax. Hey,
it's a good thing that your wife is crying.
Yeah.
And he was an atheist. And so he didn't believe in a God. He always rejected God, never believed in it. And he saw his wife walking for the first time in her life. And he starts crying. And he's like, oh my gosh, Jesus healed her.
Time to flip the switch.
So I got to like show them the gospel of just like, yeah, man, like, you know, we've all gotten separated from God at some point through a mistake, through a sin.
Yeah.
It's time to come home to him, bro. Like, this is the moment right now.
Awesome.
And they did in the middle of a Walmart in like Arizona. It was just awesome. And so like, that's what we like to do.
Yeah.
It's like there's nothing better than just having strangers get so touched by the Holy Spirit.
It's so fun, bro.
And all it is your obedience. Yeah. It's like, this is so fun. After and then they're hugging you and they're freaking out.
After that, nothing is like as fun. Yeah. Because it's like, hey, man, you want to like come out and like.
Like that's all you'd rather do is just walk around and find people that have issues and help them.
Yeah.
Totally. Yeah. Even like every now and then we'll go down to Dinky Town and we'll just walk around and talk to people.
Yeah.
And just be like, hey, man, like, what are you really going through?
Yeah.
Like, because like 80% of you down here are covering something up.
Yeah.
For you've had something happen this week, some trauma happened this week. Like,
yeah.
What's going on? And we've had like the craziest of stories through that. And it's just like, it's awesome.
Yeah.
It makes you, it just makes you want to do it all the time. And then you have to go to your job and you're like, well, can I just bring it to my job?
Yeah.
And so we do, we like bring it to like Crunch Fitness and like, that's where most of our Bible study comes from. It's just like our workplace.
Yeah. I was going to say, cause most of you or your staff at least is like the same way. No.
Yeah.
Or at least a good portion of them.
So like I started working there a year ago just about, and yeah, like I think 12 staff members have gotten saved since we started working there.
Really?
Like 8 have gotten baptized, and like we've had atheists, ex-Muslims, Mormons, like you, everybody with every background. Yeah. And we just tell them like all the time, we're like, hey man, I'm just gonna love on you. I'm just gonna show you what this love really looks like. Hindus have gotten saved. It's like people just encounter this love of Jesus that they've never felt before. Even people that grew up in the faith and they're like, I've never experienced it like this. And I'm like, that's because it's alive and you've never, like the Bible says like taste and see that the Lord is good. So many people have seen it for other people, but they've never tasted it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I could put a cheeseburger in front of you and be like, that's pretty good, right? You won't know until you bite it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So yeah,
that's what
I
we do
that.
With the gospel. Is we're like, hey, man, the Lord says to taste and see that this is good. I want you to come taste it.
Yeah.
And then we just let them taste it in that moment. And they're like, holy crap.
It is.
This is what
it.
I
want.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so then it's just been awesome. People get like healed all the time at work. Like, the craziest of stories about that.
Yeah.
Just
that's
like,
so
it's been
sick.
So fun to bring it to your workplace.
Yeah.
What's like your guys' like go-to line if like somebody walks up and is like, God's not real? Like, what do you say in that moment? Like, what is like, if you were to give like a 30-second speech to like prove to him that God is real, what is it?
Yeah.
Do you want to go first or want me to go first?
You go first.
Okay. So like, I would have like probably like two different approaches, honestly.
Kay.
Like, because I've had that happen before.
Yeah. And like, I'm sure you guys experienced
like, the that. First thing that I'll do is I'll look for the person in the room who's hurt. Like, I'll find somebody who's got a crutch, somebody who's got a busted arm, somebody who's got something going on, right? Walking with a limp or something like that. I go, okay.
Show them a miracle.
And I'll just walk over and I'll just pray for this person. And then they get touched and they get healed. They get set free, something. And then I go back to them. I go, you go tell them that God's not real because they just encountered him.
Yeah.
Like, they just encountered him. So what do you have to say about that? And they'll say whatever they want to say. Either the flips get switched or it's like, we're going to get into a little bit of a conversation.
Yeah.
Which is cool either way. You know what I mean?
Like, it's a win-win.
Yeah, and that's for us. It's like, if people come up to me and they're like, hey, man, God's not real, I'll just respond and be like, hey, man, did you know that he actually loves you so much? And Zephaniah 3:17 says that he sings songs about you. Like, he loves you so much, he sings songs about you.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not taught a lot. You know, and I'll just tell them about the love that he has for them. Like, Song of Solomon 2:15 says that he wants to build fruit with you. He wants to sit in a garden and, like, love you, bro. He calls you his bride. Have you ever been called a bride before?
No way.
Right? And dudes are like, no.
Yeah. No.
I'm like, yeah, but that's how much he loves you, dog. Like, he loves you so much, and he wants you to experience that love right now. And then what are you going to say to that? You know, like, oh, I don't want to be loved.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, everybody wants to
be loved. Everybody needs it.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
So we'll just spit the truth, because I don't really care what they say.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I mean,
we'll
it
makes
the
them
day,
think, though.
Yeah, they're going
like,
to think.
Now they're going to go home and be like,
yeah.
Right.
Maybe I was talking to Jesus right there.
Dude, 100%.
You know?
It's like, we don't need to like always have the giant debate.
Yeah.
A lot of the times it's like how we live our life is going to show them.
Right. Like debates honestly don't really do anything. All it does is like create more division.
Yeah.
We're like at work, it's easier because you see them all the time. So you can just live that life. Like people just see like his personality or like who we are. And they're like, why are you guys so happy?
Dude.
Why are you guys so joyful? Instead of like, Jesus is real, follow him. Like if it's a stranger, it's a little bit different because you got, you know, a little bit to kind of show them.
Right.
But at work, it's easier just to like live life. Because there's actually been some people who go up to Max and they're like, you're not going to get me. Like, you're not going to get me. And Max is like, okay. And then it's like 2 weeks later, they're at Bible study, and you're like,
and they're like,
gotcha. I give literally, it was just me. Like,
I'm not trying to get you, bro.
Yeah,
I'm just living life.
Right,
man.
Right. Like it, the people that want it will come, and like the people that don't just won't.
Yeah, we can't force you guys.
There's
to
nothing
do it.
I could do.
Yeah,
to make
you have to show them
for sure. Like, you're Mindy not gonna kidnap
this,
someone.
Mindy was this like, literally, he was this like Hindu dude that worked at Crunch, and he always told me, he's like, oh, I'll never be a Christian, never be a Christian. I was like, okay. And I was like,
okay,
that's
cool.
Fine. I'm like, do what you want to do, man. Like, I'm just going to live my life. And then one day he asked me, he's like, how do you have so much joy? And I was like,
yeah.
I was like, what's going around?
You know, like Nehemiah, the book of Nehemiah, like 8:10, it says that like the joy of the Lord is my strength. And so, you know, I know in his presence is the fullness of all joy. So I have joy because I have his presence with me. I was like, do you want joy? He's like, I need joy. And I was like, yeah, man, you do. He's like, you have church every Sunday? And I was like, yeah. So he comes to church, and that Sunday he gives his life to Jesus. And then it's so awesome just get to talk with him and, like, disciple him, like, through that, like, teach mm-hmm. him. He doesn't know what he's doing. He just knows he wants this God that gives joy and peace that he got to feel. So it's like, that was the easiest one ever. It was like, oh, I was just being me. You know?
Yeah, you get to teach what you love.
Yeah. But, like, I want you to say your
part. Yeah.
Yeah, which one's yours?
If somebody came up to you and was like,
God's not real, so.
Yeah. Like, you're wrong.
Dude, she's the aggressive one.
Yeah. No, honestly, at first I was going to say, like, show them the power or mm-hmm. just be like, okay, like, is there anything hurting on your body? Like, I don't know if I would necessarily look around. I would probably just go directly towards them. Like, is there anything hurting on your body? Is there anything you're going through right now? Like, will you allow me to let you pray for you and for that to be healed right now? And then, you know, I would do that because obviously you can say all these things, but unless they see the power of the Holy Spirit or of Jesus, it's a little bit harder. But yeah, then I would kind of just be like, well, do you know that Jesus actually died for you and loves you? And that's the reason you're here today. And Jesus has a purpose and a calling for you. Because I think that's when a lot of people get stuck mm-hmm. in life is, I don't have a purpose. Why am I here? I don't need to be here. Like, I don't deserve anything, whatever. And it's like, no, you actually do. Like, you're here for a reason. Everyone has their own calling, different calling, but like yours is so unique and perfect. And there's only one of you, you know? So if you waste that, you're wasting something that Jesus created. So I think just like pouring love and like teaching them what Jesus did. And then like either praying for them if they let me or praying for them as I walk away, because I know that the Holy Spirit's going to hit them when they mm-hmm. leave, when they get in their car or the next week.
At some point. Yeah.
Or be like, do you need a job? Do you need money? Like whatever. Can we pray for it? Because you're going to experience it this week. So I think that would be like awesome. My first
100%.
Yeah, interaction.
I think
with
do that one a lot too. We just like, we'll ask like, okay, like if you had an experience with God, would you follow him? And they're like, oh, of course, right? If I had an experience.
But it's like, until then, I'm not going to because I haven't seen
exactly.
it.
Yeah. Right? So then I'll ask them, like, can I just pray that God would show you how much he loves you this week? And then there's time they've come back. They've been like, okay, we have to have a conversation. You know what I mean? Like sleep paralysis, and I haven't had it all week. And I'm like,
that's nuts.
We
prayed a lot for that.
Yeah.
So I'm like, it's crazy to hear how many people do not sleep at night.
Really?
And how much that impacts, obviously, your days. But so many people are like, I see, you know, very dark, deep,
dude, like demonic
things.
I'm like, that's not from stress. You know,
right? It's not
you're
stress.
Not hearing children laughing while you sleep and like feeling claws on you.
That's not stress, bro.
Like,
that's
demonic. Like,
that's crazy.
It's a spiritual thing going on. Let's take care of it.
Yeah. Oh, and we pray and they come back. They're like, I've never slept so good in my life. Can I get baptized? And we're like,
absolutely.
You know?
That's awesome.
It is so fun.
I remember like, when I was younger, my grandpa passed away when I was probably 10 or so.
Yeah.
And like I was baptized as a really young age. Mm-hmm. I went through confirmation and whatnot. And my grandpa passed away during one of my hockey games. And I remember like getting back in the car and like my dad left because it was his dad. He left early. And I was like, and I remember just like in the middle, I'm like, oh, I wonder where he's going. And it ended up being like my grandpa passed away. And I remember getting in the car. My mom told me because we were going to go drive there.
Right.
He passed away in his bed. But we knew it was like coming. Like he had one of those like nose things, like oxygen tanks.
Air and all that. Yeah.
And so like we knew. And like I remember my mom like telling me, I was like, why? Like I was so mad. Like, why did you die during my hockey game?
Right, right.
You made my dad leave during the championship game. Like, we won. I was, like, at such a super, like, high as, like, a 10-year-old. Like, this is the greatest thing in the world. It's, like, summer hockey. Yeah. Like, in reality, it didn't matter.
Yeah.
But, like, I remember, like, during the funeral, like how my mom and my dad were always like, he was in like so much pain. Mm. And I was like, you're right. Like I was just being selfish. Yeah. Like this was the best thing for him.
Right.
And like at that moment for me, it like clicked as like, God did the right thing. Cause I feel like a lot of people, like when they talk about God is like, oh, my mom has cancer and she died.
Yeah.
Like God wouldn't want that to happen.
Yeah.
So like for me, I kind of looked at it that way, totally. But then I realized I was like, he was ready. Like,
yeah, he was ready to go.
Yeah, he was. Yeah. Like all the pain and suffering is now gone. And like now he just looks and watches my games wherever he's at.
Yeah.
So
dude, that's huge too. Yeah. Like that's a huge revelation to have because so many people are stuck on that. Like,
mm-hmm.
why did God kill my mom? Why did he kill? And that's something that we actually talk about all the time is like, what if I were to tell you that he didn't? Like John 10:10 says that like the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but I have come that you would have life and life more abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
So if Jesus has come to bring life and life more abundantly, please tell me what part of colon cancer is life and life more abundantly.
It's not. Right, it's not.
But it definitely falls under the category of stealing, killing, and destroying.
Yeah. Right.
So I know who brought that on. That's right. Satan. That's the enemy. For right? sure. That's the liar. Like,
mm-hmm.
So we get to talk about that. Like, it wasn't his will for like your mom to die when you were a kid. You know what I mean? Like, she got stolen. Like, from this world, and unfortunately, and that sucks, but so many people get mad at the wrong person.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They're like, why God? And he's like, I never wanted that.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I wanted them to live their life out. Exactly. I wanted them to have life and life more abundantly.
And just people just don't understand that.
They just don't know it. You know what I mean? That's part of it.
It's a very deep
That is unbelievable.
Yeah.
But
I love that. Yeah, we could literally talk about this for hours.
I told you we like to talk, man. We'll talk for days.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to have to do a part two, but I do want to get this little segment done because I've been looking forward to it.
So hard.
I totally forgot about
you guys are just like yelling at me. You're like, is it done yet? I'm like, hold the phone.
I'm scared.
But yeah, so I want to do this. And then I got to head to the gym around 8:00 because I have a buddy that's waiting there for me.
Sweet.
So.
Wait, what gym?
Gaines.
Crunch.
In Blaine?
Yeah. No. Maple Grove.
Maple Grove? Come on up.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Absolutely.
I was going to say, if we went to the Blaine one, we'd have problems.
No, dude, I've heard the Blaine one sucks.
Do you guys know, is it Steve? Paul Jones.
Paul Jones.
I think he used to
Paul Jones used to be a GM.
John Paul Jones?
Nope.
From Bachelorette?
Nope. Oh. I don't watch that. No, it was just Paul Jones. He used to be a manager at Crunch in Maple Grove for like, I don't know, a couple months.
He's like probably before when it first started.
Probably right before.
So I got there like 8 months after it
opened. Yeah.
I had to stop going to Crunch. I go to the YMCA in Elk River now. There's too many high schoolers that were like just huge. And I was like,
that's how it goes, man.
I've never heard anyone say they work out of the YMCA. Oh, you guys,
it is the greatest thing in the world. Hear me out.
They got to watch the clip, bro.
What's the clip? Of him posing. It's unbelievable. But
when you like pass out?
No. This is even funnier.
I got like friends. Like we got hot tubs. You don't have hot tubs?
No,
at Crunch? You don't have a pool at Crunch?
No. Do you have a water slide? You have a water slide?
I got a water slide.
Water slide.
I got a sauna. Dude, I know you guys
what's
have
like
a sauna.
What's the age range there, though?
Oh, like 6 3 to 25, 90.
Dude, we got the Holy Spirit flowing in our gym, though.
Yeah, well, I got the Holy Spirit flowing in my ears when I listen to music, so he's...
I don't got to be a battle of, like, YMCA and Crunch?
Yeah, wow.
Like,
so down.
Yeah, do you have a song for the gym that you go to? No.
What?
I do. YMCA.
That's whack.
That's actually true.
They got it playing the whole time you're there. Why? You just... memorize that. I'm just kidding.
So if you forget your headphones one day, you're like,
dude, that would drive me crazy.
That's hilarious.
You're like,
anyway, so the Sophia's posing coach, or not Sophia's, Olivia's posing coach came on our podcast last week, and Nate was so excited to like ask her if she could critique one of my poses.
Yeah,
I was
so like, this is the clip that we got out of it.
It's unbelievable.
Hilarious.
All right, pick your favorite pose. I would go, but I don't.
He's loving it.
Shit, this is way off. Oh, this is gonna be good. This is gonna be good.
Okay, little front double by.
She just called me out. Oh my god.
Let's go, Max. Go. Ooh.
Ooh.
I haven't posted it yet, but I was like, you guys would appreciate it because your gym goers.
Oh my god,
so funny! Just straight up.
Was she like nice about it?
Yeah, she was, and I think she meant it more of like I wasn't flexing my legs instead of like you have scrawny legs.
Yeah,
that's hilarious.
Where are your legs at, Max?
I was like,
chicken legs.
Just call me out like that, why don't you?
Anyways, all right. Let's see how smart we are now.
Let's see how smart you are. Okay. So we're going to call this one back to school. So we're going to answer, or I'm going to ask you questions, grades 1 through 12. Almost said 10. Grades 1 through 12. And you're going to answer them as a team. So you have to both agree on the answer.
Goodness.
All right. To get the answer. If you fail three questions, you don't graduate.
Fair enough.
So three, ooh, you have to, you have to pass. Yeah. All right. Grade number one. What color is a basketball?
It's orange.
I feel like it's a trick question, though.
I coach college ball. It's orange. It's orange.
Yes, correct.
You like that's orange.
Definition of an overthinker is like right there. Right.
Yeah.
All right. Grade number two. What sound does a duck make?
It makes quack.
Final answer.
Quack. Yes. Like,
quack.
Like you were about to make the noise. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, correct. So you're 2 for 2 right now. Oh, grade number three. What is 3 times 3?
9.
I gave you the preview.
Yeah. You should change that. You should have been like 5 plus 5.
What's 5 plus 5?
10.
Yeah. Okay, you're 3 for 3 right now. All right, grade number four. What is a good conductor of electricity?
Ooh, there's a couple answers, but copper for sure, gold for sure.
So it's so quiet.
She's like, I had no clue.
Copper.
Yes, ding, 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 correct. You got it right.
I got it.
You're 4 for 4 right now, so you're on a roll.
It took me a hot minute to get that one. I was like, conductor, like train conductor.
Yeah, right. Yeah, Bill Nye. Oh my God, that guy came in clutch. Grade number five, name one country that isn't the United States.
Ooh.
Name one country that isn't the United States.
I think Soph has to do this one.
Why?
I don't know.
Why is he mean?
He's got them all.
If he's questioning, then I don't know.
Canada.
It's okay, good. Okay, you're 5 for 5, but this is where they kind of start to turn up. So you might want to
middle school.
Flip your switch. Yeah, middle school. Oh, gosh, here we go. Grade number six. Who was the first president of the United States?
Is it George Washington? George Washington.
Ooh.
No. Yeah.
I don't have a degree.
I was gonna say, I'm waiting for one of you to say Lincoln. All right. Grade number seven. Name any president from the 20th century.
Oh, done. Locked.
From the 20th century. That's huge. Not the 21st century.
Nope.
So we got to go back.
What century are we in now?
We're in the 21st.
Yeah.
So we got to go with like Reagan. Reagan.
Yes! Come on, I did it!
I was thinking Bill Clinton.
He was on there, too.
Work. Okay.
Yep,
all right,
yep,
yeah.
Yep.
All
right. Yep. You could have done that.
Yeah, I was thinking that, too.
Yeah. Shout out, Bill.
Yeah.
Shout out,
Bill. All right. 6 for 6, or 7 for 7, excuse me. Grade number 8. What is the Earth's primary reason for gravitational pull?
Earth's primary reason for gravitational pull?
Yeah.
This is a 7th grade question.
Primary reason. Like, what causes gravitational pull?
Yes. Well, like, what is, like...
Or, like, why do we like it?
No, like, why, what is, what causes Earth's main gravitational pull?
It'd be the, like, the... Jesus.
Jesus is always the answer.
It'd be, like, the Earth's core, right? Like, the Earth's core pulls everything in. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the... Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay.
You may proceed.
The Earth's core.
Right. Incorrect. Oh. It's actually the moon.
Yeah,
the
moon. I knew it.
I was actually gonna say that.
Why didn't you say it? You got
he was getting it all right.
You would have gotten 8 for 8.
Wait, the moon is the reason we have gravity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't ask me why, man. I have no
I'm
clue.
I'm hitting Google after this. Sure.
You can fact check me, but no, I got it off TikTok. So TikTok's got to be right. Okay, so you're 7 for 8. Right. You have 2 more incorrects until you don't graduate high school.
Uh-oh. We got it.
We'll be fine.
Got it.
Grade number 9. You're in high school now.
Ooh.
How many legs does a lobster have?
Oh my gosh! How many legs?
Yeah.
Legs.
Yeah.
Not arms.
Not the claws.
Nope.
Not the claws.
Claws don't count.
Crap, dude. It's got to be 6 or 8, right? Because I feel like they like skimper around. They do like that.
What?
You know what I mean? Like they're like.
I'm thinking of a crab.
Wait, what did you say? Lobster? I was thinking of crab too.
Yeah, I was gonna say crabs have 4.
It's got to be 6 or 8.
You think?
Yeah.
A lobster?
Yeah.
Have you ever eaten a lobster before?
Yeah, I worked at Crave.
Those are probably fake lobsters.
He went from Crave to Crave Crunch. Anything else with C's coming up?
I've been everywhere.
What's Crown next? University.
Crown. Oh boy.
Church.
church.
Yep. Wow.
Everything's just C's.
Everything's C. Soon it's going to be California.
Throw up C's?
Yeah. Yeah, throw up C's.
We're moving.
Oh, yeah, we're going to Cali?
Yeah.
Six or eight?
Sure.
Which one?
I would say less.
Six? Yeah, you tell them. So you can
or four. Or two. Six.
Incorrect. Oh. It's actually eight.
Oh.
Wow. Yes.
Oh. Why do you say that?
See, gosh. School's hard. School's hard, right, man.
We gotta
yeah.
go plus these last.
Okay. You have one more incorrect until you don't graduate school. Okay. And these are where they get really hard.
Yeah, okay. Harder. So wait, so what? Right,
you're sophomores. You're in grade 10.
I just transferred. Okay.
Grade number 10. What is the smallest ocean in the world?
Oh my gosh. I know what the warmest is.
What?
The Indian Ocean.
Okay. I will give you that it's not the Indian Ocean.
Okay. Now, is it bad that I can only think of two?
What are you thinking of?
Well, there's the Pacific and Atlantic.
Okay, which one's the biggest?
Those ones are for sure huge, though.
Yeah.
They can't be the smallest. Yeah. Neither of those can be the smallest.
Correct.
I have zero. I don't even know any more oceans. Indian, Pacific, and Atlantic. That's it.
I know beaches.
Arctic? Is the well, Antarctic? Just,
yeah.
That might be.
Is that an ocean?
I think so. I think it is.
The Arctic Ocean?
It sounds
the Arctic Ocean?
Yeah, the one by Antarctica.
It starts with an A.
Atlantis.
You're so close.
At last.
Oh, man.
The ocean. Oh. That's the smallest.
It's a city.
You just said Atlantis. But it starts with an A and it sounds like Atlantis.
Come on. Atlantis. I don't know. I'm trying to help you.
Bro, my face hurts from smiling so much.
Say, should we pray about it real quick?
Yeah. Lord, give us clarity.
Show us.
Atlantis.
Oh, snap.
Atlas.
Not the palms.
Atlas. Can't be Atlas.
It's you're so close. Like, just change the way you say that last.
Atlantis.
Atlas.
At last. The ocean.
Atlas.
You're so close.
Atlas. Atlantic?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah! See, the prayer worked.
Yeah, stone fed on that one. Okay.
All right, so you got that one. I feel like these next two you can get on your own. Grade number 11. Where did the Olympics originate from?
Oh, that's like ancient Greece. Would you agree?
Yeah.
ancient Greece. Ancient Greece. Okay, good.
Okay. Minnesota.
I was thinking Rome.
I mean, is Rome that's not like in the Greece? Same.
Is it?
They're not the same thing, but they okay. look alike.
They're the same.
They look alike. Okay. Same thing.
Same thing.
They would have been friends.
All right, grade number 12. You have two incorrect. If you fail this, you do not graduate school.
All
right. Well, we need our diploma.
We have a million, a billion, a trillion.
Oh, yeah.
Spider.
What comes after a trillion?
Oh. It's quadrillion.
Say that one more time.
We have a million, a billion, a trillion, and then what?
I think it's quadrillion.
Okay.
Final answer, quadrillion?
He doesn't even know.
I don't even know.
Oh. That gives us more time to think.
Yeah, quick, let's change your answer.
Okay, final answer, quadrillion?
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, that scares me.
Look at his face.
Yeah?
Should we watch this?
I got a good poker face.
It sounds right. Because think about quad means four, so that makes sense. Like,
oh yeah, okay.
Ding ding ding! You're right. Yeah! Yeah! I got you thinking about it though. I got you thinking about
yeah,
it.
That was mean. I didn't like that.
Hey, I'm trying to win. The school system always tries to win, but that was fun. Thanks for playing that, wasn't it?
Oh, that was a blast.
So glad we graduated.
That was a blast. Yeah, I'm glad. I mean, congrats, now you can guys. Move on with your life, right?
Go get a college. Job now. 9 to 5. Here we come.
Yep.
Yeah, we'll show them this video. Be like, this is our what's it called?
Resume.
It's like portfolio resume.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Same thing. So, well, let's wrap this one up. We're going to run a part two back in a couple weeks because that was unbelievable. Wrap it up.
Yeah, we'll freestyle.
Yeah, right?
We'll put you guys in a booth. Get that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we appreciate you guys having us.
Absolutely.
Yeah, awesome. Thank
yeah,
you.
It was a blast. I hope you guys have fun.
Yes.
And we're going to have you back because
this was awesome. So fun.
We have a long lot more to
we
talk about.
We have so many things to talk about. Yeah. I feel like we didn't even talk about. Like, part of me is like, what about you guys?
Yeah, right? Like, no.
Boring life. We got to yeah, so trust me.
We're just realtors.
Like, I don't hop on special. Planes and chase down ex-girlfriends. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I don't.
That's what you got out of this?
I don't.
It's his ex?
I don't. I don't ask the cashier at the gas station just so I can pray for her. I'm sorry. I just
now you can start.
I just
now
you can start. Can I get 30 on pump 3, please? that's what I do.
That's hilarious.
But yeah, thank you.
We do. You forgot the most important question of the night.
I didn't forget it. I was letting you do it.
Okay. I feel a little special now. Yeah. Anyways.
Never fight.
We always ask this question at the end of like every podcast, and it's what is one thing in your life that you would either go back and tell your younger self or yourself in the future?
Ooh.
Do we answer both?
Yeah.
Or one?
Yeah.
You can each say your
each,
what you would
yeah.
do.
You could pick one of the two.
Oh, one of the
past
two.
Or future.
Ooh. I would say I'd probably go to my past and tell myself to not be stupid.
Very specific.
Yeah.
Well,
like sometimes like being not specific. What's the opposite of specific?
Vague.
Vague. Yeah. Being very vague is like the simplest answer.
100%.
I would think.
I would definitely tell my younger self. Dude, I'm trying to think what age I would go to, though. I'd probably go to, like, me in, like, sixth grade.
Mm-hmm.
And one, I'd be like, dude, do not go on that website. But then I would just tell him, I'd be like, live with the Holy Spirit, bro. Like, you've been raised right. You've been raised in this. Just pick it. Just mm-hmm. choose it. Start living it out. Mm-hmm. And stay away from porn. Stay away from girls, you know, until you're, like, 20.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Not porn. Like, you need to talk to girls when you're 20. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't just, like, ignore them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I definitely, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's good.
Go with Jesus, bro.
Yeah.
Nothing else.
I'd probably say, I don't know, maybe college. Like, before going to college, I would say, like, find the Holy Spirit. Find those people who will show you the power. But also, like, people will follow you.
Mm-hmm.
I think that'd be my biggest thing is, like, don't keep following other people. But, like, you do what you need to do and people will follow you because I'm a leader.
Yeah.
Like, that's my personality. Mm-hmm. So cause I feel like I missed my personality a lot. So let's say that.
That's
love
great.
That.
Yeah, that's kind of
that's
a bar,
amazing.
Too.
Like, yeah.
Don't follow people. People will follow you.
Yeah, can we throw you on a Lil Wayne rap song?
That's crazy.
Yeah, we got Drake. I got Drake's number.
We do it all.
That's I love it. So, yeah.
Who's the most famous person in your contact? Want to FaceTime him for us?
Yeah. Who do we have?
I don't have many famous people.
Well, you have us now.
Yeah, right? Which is funny. I actually don't have your number. I just have Matt. Yeah, so we just snap.
Yeah. Park Nicollet did just send me a text
there
message.
There you go.
I mean, I feel like they're pretty famous.
Yeah, he had a Super Bowl commercial this year.
Yeah, I don't know if they're getting a
lawyer, I think.
I was like, am I going to be embarrassed for not knowing who that is?
No, Park Nicollet, like the medical company.
I was like a Nicolet.
Hi, Nate.
Oh, the lawyer, dude.
Hi, Nate. Park Nicollet.
He was like,
friendly
a
reminder.
Lawyer, I think.
Give an appointment Wednesday.
So
March
obviously, we 20th. Don't care.
Yeah. Obviously, we're not up to date in our health insurance.
I don't have anybody popular.
I'll go
Matt Hellickson.
Matt Hellickson. That's hilarious. That was like my sister's best friend back
really?
In the day.
Yeah. I would probably go Matt Hellickson. He's pretty famous.
Yeah.
He's becoming a painter/artist now.
No way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good for him. Mm-hmm. He's a hockey guy. Played in like the Olympics and stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
He's pretty cool.
Yeah, I don't know who I would say. I'd have to look.
I feel like the best way we should end this is with a prayer. I feel like
dude,
it's
for
only,
sure.
I feel like it's only fitting
it is
that you guys are here.
Yeah, and you guys are going to pray.
I was hoping you guys were going to lead it. I'll sit here and like bow my
say
head and like.
You guys are each going to say a prayer and we're going to rate it.
Dude, yeah, we'll for sure pray. But then we'll pray after this too.
About yeah, like
if you guys
love that.
Okay.
Big stuff
yeah.
Too.
Perfect.
Don't need to like throw your business out there. But
yeah, we can do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, let's do that.
Mm-hmm. You want to pray or you want me to?
Oh.
Should we both?
I'll kick it off. You finish it.
Okay.
Perfect.
Sounds good.
I love that.
Old school style.
I love this.
All right. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for today. Thank you, God, that we could just be on this podcast, Lord, with these two great guys. I just pray for favor over this new chapter that they're opening together, Lord, in this podcast and with their real estate as well. I pray that you just reveal yourself to them in that, just show them your love that you have for them. I just pray that you'd give them safe travels, that you'd guard about them, that you'd align the correct people in their life, Lord, that you'd give them wisdom, and that whenever they call out to you, Lord, whenever they look for you, whenever they search for you, that you would be there for them, Lord. Like your word says that if we seek you diligently with our full heart, you will reveal yourself to us. So yeah. I pray that you just show up in their life anywhere they're hurting. I pray for me and Soph that you'd guard about us in our ministry and in this chapter of our life, that anywhere we look, anywhere we go, we'd put you first, Lord, that mm-hmm. nothing else would get in the way except for the love that you have for us and the love that we have for you, Lord.
Yeah, Lord, thank you so much for this opportunity, just that we have all this technology to use to just get the word out there, and for all the people that have sat in these chairs and to talk and just enjoy company and to be friends with one another. We just pray for this podcast as well, that so many people can look at what they're doing, and especially with their jobs within real estate and just their daily lives with work and their extra free time and everything, Lord. We just pray blessings over this room, and when they leave, that there's also so many blessings out there as well, and that the Holy Spirit's just flowing, and that there's way more opportunities to just preach the gospel. But we just thank you for this time, that you're just in this room with us, and that there's just amazing, cool stories that come out of this because your power is so great. So, in the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amazing. Thank
Unreal.
You.
Unreal.
Yeah.
Appreciate it, guys.
Love that.
Is that what he does at the end?
That's what Nate does at the end.
That is it. The MN Talk Show. Max Manny's already out of here. But in the meantime, y'all have a blessed day.